Plenty kena tatkani khatvasa deshitana hajaneri ah ani ayakhat. This is our land. This is where I come from. I am the Night Madness. I come from the Steel House and the Springwater House. And we are of the Deshitan Raven Beaver, Edge of the Nation People clan. And this land belongs to the Steel House of Angoon.
The Cube Cove Restoration Project includes four large watersheds that span nearly 23,000 acres, including three lakes and over 150 miles of streams. About 20 to 40 years ago, industrial scale logging occurred in these watersheds, and it constructed over 214 miles of roads and clear-cut nearly the entire area. We plan to restore hydrologic function and improve fish habitat quality and connectivity by removing culverts and bridges, installing water bars on roads that are preventing water from flowing downhill, and by applying stream restoration and riparian thinning treatments to help get large woody debris back in aquatic habitats. Overall, these efforts will help to restore the untrammeled, natural, and undeveloped characteristics of wilderness.
Angoon's got a long history here. I mean, thousands and thousands of years, but also they fought to have this area permanently protected. And they did so through Jimmy Carter and a designation called Wilderness through the Alaska National Interest Lands Conservation Act. And that was back in the 60s and early 70s.
That was a couple of generations ago. The people that had actually advocated and went to Congress and spoke with the president. It's like it's come full circle. We get to come back and fix the one area that they were not able to protect. It means a lot because this is literally where I come from. It's my home.
While it looks like it's healing itself, conditions are actually getting worse.
After logging, the deer hunting's really good for 20 years, and then the trees get to a certain point and they become blockers. They block all the sun, and then there's no food for the deer. Well, it's in that seclusion stage where there's no food for the deer now.
You see a lack of deer prints, a lack of bear prints, a lack of any signs that there's anything living here.
It's like the opposite of the old growth. The new growth, they're very thick and the canopy's super, super dark. You have no light penetrating to the ground and you get this really uniform, thick, dark understory.
It's unmistakably clear that it is in an unhealthy condition.
Trees are critical to fish habitat. When you clear cut over the top of a stream, you remove the trees that are standing that provide critical resources like shade and bugs that fall into the stream, but over time you remove that wood that's in the stream itself. We're gonna fix that process by going through thick second growth forest that's right on the edge of the stream and selecting the trees that we think are gonna be the ones that are gonna grow big, fast, and we're cutting out their competition by thinning out the rest.
As soon as we hired these guys, I've tried to instill pride in our work, explaining to them the type of work we're going to be doing and why we're going to be doing it, that it's literally our very own homeland, and we want to do a good job, you know, and we want to represent Angoon.
Feels like we're making a difference.
It feels good to be working on our home territory finally.
I seen the crew in tears one day out there. How much this means to them because of their great-grandparents and their great-great-grandparents. This is the land where they got their kokanee salmon. This is the land that produced food for them and deer. And to have the crews out there doing this, knowing they're working in conjunction with what our ancestors would have wanted us to do, that makes them proud and it makes me proud.
This project is facilitating an opportunity for these guys to apply skills that they already have to do important work and make an earnest dollar for their hard effort. There's a lot of opportunity to continue working and to bring more folks from their community, younger generations, up into this work, not only on the ecosystem side of the Tongass National Forest, but also on the recreation side.
To have a job in Angoon that pays competitive wages and helps out your family, that's a big deal. There are so many people over the years growing up in Angoon that I've watched leave Angoon because there are no opportunities. There's nothing there.
This project in my mind is just really exemplary because it's a win, win, win. We're restoring fish habitat. We're bettering the environment for this place in a direct and meaningful way. We're hiring locals. And third is we're creating a partnership. We've got the Forest Service out here, we got folks from Angoon out here, and we got the Southeast Alaska Watershed Coalition, a community group out here. And we're working together hand in hand to steward and take care of this place. And I really think that's the future of what the Tongass National Forest is. We have a lot of small communities, a lot of native communities who have always been a part of this land, and building those communities into the way the Tongass National Forest is managed is the future of what we're going to do here. And I'm pretty excited to see Cube Cove being kind of the cutting edge of that in this part of the Tongass.
Working with the different Southeast Alaska Native crews is, I think it's the heart of the Forest Service right now. I think it's the direction that we're going in. You know, having these partnerships is priceless.
Hope our people are just as excited as us and all the people that are coming out here to help us with our restoration. I hope our people are just as happy and as excited as we are, and everybody that comes from other places that aren't from here.
It's Gunnus Cheese from the Kootz Crew. We really appreciate our work and being able to work in our own territory. It is a true blessing.